All right, I'm on hole number 9 of the Fuji Open. Let's go to Golf Clash Notebook and check out hole number 9. I want to stop here for a second. And yesterday I had something happen here. I was reading the poll and people were talking about, you know, when you're in a tournament, you come down here, you go here, you get an albie, your opponent ended up in the rough over here and couldn't get on. And then they would lay up, so there's two shots, and then they're on in three, and maybe, let's say they didn't make it, so they're looking at birdie, but because you hit the albie, they ended up getting an eagle. And one of the things was, is that, hey, let's make this so you can play out. And I get it. But yesterday I had something happen, which is another reason why I think it's important that we, that Playdemic, actually take a look at making people play out. I came out here, ended up in the absolute perfect spot that I wanted to be in to do this rough bump to go for albie. My opponent came out here, hit in the water, and then forfeited the match, and I got an eagle. Okay, I got an eagle. There was no guarantee that I was going to get over here and that I was going to get the eagle, but the point is that I didn't even get to look at the albie shot, and I put myself in the right spot, so I got cheated because my opponent forfeited. So I'm not a big, and this isn't the first time that that's happened where I put myself in a perfect spot, my opponent hit a bad shot and then got ticked and forfeited, and then I ended up not being able to take the shot that I set up. So I think they do need to do something about that. In real play, if I went out there and hit an albatross, then I'm going to have to wait for my opponent to get on and do all their stuff. In real golf, it's all about who's farther forward, so we're going to end up, you know, but they could look at that. There should be something that they can do so that we can continue to play through. I'm going to bring my accurate bag, and I'm going to bring a Titan. And I think that's all I need. Off we go. I'm not opening up any more tour, I'm not opening up those tour three chests to fill in gaps if I win, because I've got the Tour 3 and below clubs that I want maxed, so there isn't anything down there that I'm hoping to get more clubs for. And if you're playing in the rookie tournaments and you want better clubs, then you're going to have to get that done in one-on-one play. It always cracks me up when people go, well, your clubs are good enough. You should have to play in expert, or you should have to play in pro, or you should have to play in masters. Which is funny, because in real golf, you can go down and buy the most expensive set of clubs on day one or the cheapest clubs on day one. And just because somebody went out there and bought a set of Nikes and paid $3,000 doesn't mean that all of a sudden they can't go play. You know, it doesn't change your handicap. You can have the best equipment in the world, but if you don't know how to play, you don't know how to play. I mean, the goal here is to give myself a little bit of room here. I want my orange ring to be kind of centered so that I have lots of maneuverability. I'm going to leave the wind in. Go ahead and take the shot. And I'm going to put some right hand curl on it to bring it back so that I have a better shot coming into the green. Hitting it perfect. The fear here is that wind will actually make the ball go too far forward and I'll end up in the rough, just like I did right there. So I'm going to need to take a little bit of that wind out. Earlier in the week, there was like a 2.5 wind and it was fine, and then there was a 3 wind and it was still fine, but the 4.2 was a little much. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to make a note here. To wind, if over, take out. So I'll leave 2 of the wind in to help push me forward, but I'm going to take everything else out. So in that 4-2 right there, I would have taken 1 ring of wind out so that I'd end up in the right spot. Now, I stood still because I'm so far forward. I should still have a nice shot here. I'm going to have to bounce it off the island. I won't be able to do the rough bump. But I should still have a nice shot here with my Nirvana. And if my Nirvana's in max club, it's about 2 per ring. My opponent's very lucky that they're in the fairway and not on the rough. I could do a rough bump from here. Could do the rough bump. Where's my max club? So I'm eking towards max club here. I can still get the... So it's 2.8, so that's about a ring and a half. Just slightly less than a ring and a half. Now it's just all boiling down to hit it perfect. Oh, I got some lag right there. That was total lag stuff. It went from one side all the way over to the hook on the other side. And on my... Wow. That was horrid. The good news there is that I actually feel lucky on that it didn't go in that sand, because I really wouldn't have wanted to take the sand shot. I got a pretty decent shot of being able to put this in from here, but the sand would have definitely diminished my chances. But that was horrid. So where's my max club? So max club's out there. So I'm in that range where it's about... So we're at 4-5. So I'm going to go right over into this range right here. Go right on the edge of the cup. And the goal here is I have to hit this perfect. Oh, and I hit it great to the left. I was so freaked out that I was going to get another lag that I actually hit it great to the left. Went the whole round, shot great, picked up one, was looking at a minus 13 and ended up dropping one on hole number 9. Jeez. And that's, you know, I saw in the poll people were talking about glitches in the game. That's not a glitch from Playdemic's part. That lag is all on my side. Either my connection got bad or something happened, and we've got storms in the area, so it could very easily could have just been something on my side. So that's how you drop a shot. Good or bad, that's how it works. You have to roll with the punches. You have to take that in stride. If you let a shot like that affect you, that hole's going to affect you for the next 2 or 3 holes, and then you're going to find yourself in a situation where you're in big trouble. All right, that was hole number 9 of the Fuji Open Tournament and the opening round of the rookie division. Thanks for watching.